Today, we're gonna be taking pictures of lights. That's right, I said it, and I'm not afraid to say it. We're gonna be taking pictures of lights on trees and things. Some considerations when doing this. You wanna shoot when it's a little bit dimmer outside. That way, there's just enough ambient light to illuminate the things around the lights. Also, you want your white balance either to be tungsten for a cooler look, or you set your white balance to daylight for a warmer look. It's up to you. That's enough information to get started with. Let's get cracking. I'm out here during solar transit. That's when the sun is as high and bright in the sky as it's gonna be for this particular day in this particular location. That means that the light is so garishly bright, you can't really see the lights. It's really no use taking a picture of lights when it's so bright outside. So you might think to yourself, oh, I'll come back when it's dark outside. Kind of like right now, it's very dark out and the camera really has to fight to get me well exposed. So right now is not really the time of night to be taking pictures of your lights and getting the best shots you can get. So what I'd recommend you do instead is you want to shoot in a Goldilocks time, when it's not too bright and it's not too dark, but it's kind of in the middle. It's just right, Goldilocks. So you want to shoot at a time kind of like right now. The light is perfect. It's not too bright and it's not too dark. It's right in the middle, like Goldilocks. It's just right. It is just gorgeous right now. This is the perfect time to be taking pictures of your lights because you can see me, you can see the lights, you can see the Rensen. It's just a happy world we all live in right now. At this brief moment, I guess you might call it twilight light, morning twilight and evening twilight. It's important to shoot at the right time of day, no matter what you're taking a picture of. Photographers are called chasers of light. And right now, in the realm of taking pictures of lights, this is the light you want to be in to be doing that outdoors. To do a comparison between all these lighting situations, these times of the day, I want my camera person to do a 360 pan around and you can see, make the comparison. As you can see, at least between day and night, diurnal and nocturnal, the light changes dramatically and you really get a different scene in which to take your photographs. There's this kind of a golden hour that's happening right now where it's dawn right now, and later we're gonna hopefully come back when it's dusk. And everything is, the ambient light, everything's kind of lit, and the lights, of course, they emit light, so they're lit as well. And so you get the perfect exposure every time. We're gonna go up here to this park, Campus Martius Park, and I'll show you how to do that. You see right here, I have a blue sky in the background because the white balance is tungsten. Now I'm gonna switch it to daylight. Oh, it's still kind of blue, but like I said, it's got a warmer look to it. Now I don't quite have a wide enough lens to get this whole tree in frame. So I have to pick the most interesting part of it, and the base isn't that interesting. I'm just gonna get the very top of it. And I have to watch the background to make sure I'm not putting the building in there either. I centered the tree and I put it to either side off-center just to give myself options when I get home, which one I like the best. You always wanna do that when taking pictures. Bring it in. All right, that's in enough. Kids, get out there, take some beautiful photographs and make me proud. Okay, watch out, there's a car coming.